So despite how long the typical player has been exploring in Wizard 101, questions about the sites existing far beyond Ravenwood and many other curiosities such as hidden magic and the origins of NPCs always remain a wonder. This video is dedicated to sharing some of the most interesting things that King's Isle themselves have revealed about Wizard 101 in the past. Most of these things are very surprising and thought-provoking, and they deserve to be known by the players. So the first few questions that have been answered by King's Isle are, where is the Arcanum? What is the creed of the Arcanum, and how were the scholars chosen? King's Isle has said, the Arcanum is both inside and outside the spiral. It's a part of it, but also apart from it. It was created using obscure magics, deep hidden arcane laws far beyond the scope of anything you may have learned at Ravenwood. The purpose of its isolation is to give the scholars there an unbiased perspective of spiral events and to make sure they can protect against threats that come from outside the spiral. Such threats cannot even be perceived from within the spiral. Okay, so the first thing that King's Isle said was that the Arcanum is not inside of the spiral, but it's also not outside of it. It's a part of it, but it's also apart from it. So basically, my wonder is if the Arcanum is sort of in between the spiral and whatever is on the other side of the spiral, then what is on that other side and how dangerous is it? So another cool thing that King's Isle mentioned was that there are many obscure magics out there in the spiral, and the Arcanum was created with some of those. So you have to imagine that that means that our scholars know about some of those magics and we don't. Finally, they say how such threats cannot even be perceived from within the spiral. Now, this is actually pretty similar to something that was mentioned a long time ago in the game in Briskbreeze Tower. At the end of it, the guard who helps you mentions how the enemy, after you defeat him, he says that there will be a new threat coming to the spiral, and the guard is like, how can something be coming to the spiral? So I think, simply put, this is just proof that there's much more out there in the spiral. King's Isle has stated that the Arcanum Creed is, in the order, a spiral, in the spiral, a magic, in the magic, an eternity, in the eternity, a truth. Now that is an awesome creed. There's not even much more that needs to be said about it. You could actually build some theories from what the creed says. In the spiral, a magic, in the magic, an eternity. So does that mean that the magic is actually what's fueling our wizards and people within the spiral? Does the spiral being order mean that the people of the Arcanum think that there's nothing wrong with the spiral and it's perfect even though it's all shattered? Does the truth that they refer to mean that we're still looking for that truth, or have they already uncovered it? There's a lot that you could take from that creed, and it's just an awesome thing to say in general. King's Isle tells us that the scholars of the Arcanum have come through it through many pathways. Some have been there since its original founding. Others discovered it through their own magical research, gained access, and were then convinced to stay. And of course, there are those who were recruited, sometimes by the other scholars as a collective, and sometimes, as in the wizard's case, recruited by a single scholar who saw tremendous potential. So we've been told by King's Isle how the scholars got here, and they also let us know that some of them found their way here through their own magical research, which, if you remember, the Arcanum is very difficult to see from the spiral. Like, it's hidden, and it was made with all this powerful magic. So if our professors here were able to find their way to the Arcanum, then they must be very smart and very powerful. Ione and Ignis Ferrick, I think, are definitely the two professors who found their way here through their own magical research, because Ione comes from Imperia and Ignis comes from the Broken Shores, and they wouldn't really have any reason to leave those places unless they were studying their magic and happened to find the Arcanum and then decided that living here would be much better than living there because of the crisis that are happening, especially in Imperia, which will be the next world that we have to save from the bat. So definitely very interesting to think about, and King's Isle has provided us with this information. So now let's move on to the next three questions that King's Isle have answered that not many players know about. Who founded the Arcanum? What's outside of the spiral? And is Old Cobb really evil? King's Isle's response to a player who asked this question was very interesting. Strange as it may sound, the founding of the Arcanum is a bit of a mystery, even to many of the scholars themselves. Who had such foresight to predict the need for such an organization? What magnitude of magic was required to construct it in this seemingly impossible space? These questions sometimes keep us awake at night as well. As to the Arcanum's motives, indeed, by their creed, they certainly seem duty-bound to protect the spiral. Do they have other motives as well? I suspect they do, if not as a collective, then at the very least as individuals. I get the sense that most of the scholars have passions and interests relating to other matters. So it sounds as if we don't really know who created the Arcanum, but we do know that it apparently took a large magnitude of magic to come up with the Arcanum, and that definitely raises the question of whoever came up with the idea to start the Arcanum had to have been a very powerful being, or had access to some very powerful magic. Now, King Zhao has also let us know that all of the scholars have their own passions that they like to pursue, and I definitely believe this, especially the balance scholar Jackie Whispermoran. I believe that she likes to explore different worlds and that she's been to the Hidden Lands. King Zhao had this to say about what's outside of the spiral. The nature of the intergalactic phenomena that can be seen from the Arcanum's windows has not yet been explained to the wizard, but this much I can say. The Arcanum scholars do indeed know much about what's out there, how it relates to the spiral, and how it relates to that which is not the spiral as we know it. That said, I don't think it's safe to assume there are other worlds outside the spiral. There is something out there, but it might be dangerous to even think about it. This answer is definitely an important one. What is this danger outside the spiral, and why do we constantly hear about it? What could it do to the spiral, and will we ever have a chance to prevent it ourselves? Here are King Zhao's thoughts on whether Old Cobb is evil. Old Cobb is indeed a mystery. He clearly wants to destroy the spiral, but what exactly his motives might be, I'm not sure I fully understand. Is he truly evil? He certainly doesn't seem to be friendly. He sometimes reminds me of Malastare. Was Malastare truly evil? This response is really, really interesting, and King Zhao reinstates a lot of the theories and conspiracies that a lot of the players have come up with about whether or not Old Cobb is actually evil, and they even compare him to Malastare and raise the question of whether Malastare was ever truly evil. And if you think about Malastare, he was a guy who did a lot of bad things because his heart was broken, and comparing him to Old Cobb isn't too much different. Old Cobb feels betrayed and he feels broken and shattered because of how Grandmother Reed treated him, locking him down here in this pit. So is Old Cobb really a bad guy, or is he just doing some things that seem bad? The next confirmed secrets by King Zhao are Ione's paintings of Imperia? What is the Sleeping Arcanum Tree's name? And is Jackie from Cool Ranch or some other eastern half of colonial America? King Zhao had simple responses to these questions. That painting in Ione's office is quite impressive, isn't it? Yes, I've been meaning to ask her where that came from. Shh, if I say her name, it might wake her up. Jackie Whispermoran does not come from Cool Ranch. To say more would be to say too much. Alright, so I know you guys are thinking right now, how could you possibly build any kind of theory off of those three simple answers from King Zhao? And while that is true, the three answers actually were kind of hints at certain things. In the first answer of whether or not the paintings in Aloni's classroom came from Imperia, he actually doesn't confirm it, but he does make a little joke about how he's been meaning to ask her where they came from. And I think if they weren't from Imperia, then he would have just straight up said no. Why would he joke around like that? And also, you have to keep in mind the fact that in Wisteria, there was a small little hint that somebody ordered some sky squid ink from Imperia. And Imperia is actually known for delivering certain things throughout the spiral. They have a little trade post in the world. So, Ione could have had her, you know, painting delivered to her classroom. That could be a possibility. Or, it could have just been a little joke just to make us wait a little longer for Imperia for when it comes out. The next answer of whether or not the tree in the Arcanum has a name, it's not answered, but he says that if he says her name, he might wake her up. And that is right there a hint that she can wake up, and that she probably one day will wake up in the game, because why would she be there as an NPC if she's never going to wake up? That doesn't really make much sense. Or we might find out her backstory of why she can't wake up. And in the final answer of whether or not Jackie is from Cool Ranch, this right here is the most important answer for me, really, in all of these little secrets that King Zhao has revealed to us. Is Jackie from Cool Ranch, or is she from another eastern colonial half of America? No, she is not from Cool Ranch. And this is so big to me because many people in the past have said to me, Sorcerer, Jackie is not from the Hidden Lands, as I believe. They've said, she's from Cool Ranch, from Pirate 101. And that's not true. King Zhao confirmed it themselves, and I will leave the link in the description. I'll tell you guys all about it at the end of the video. But no, she's not from Cool Ranch, and that is big because I believe she's from the Hidden Lands, the final, or one of the final worlds in the third arc. And there's even more proof to this because they also say, not only is she not from Cool Ranch, but they say to say it more would be to say too much. Now, she might not be from the Hidden Lands exactly, But that definitely has to mean that she comes from somewhere important in the third arc, and that they have a plan for her. She matters in the storyline. So those three answers, while they were very simple and didn't say much, they actually did give away a lot of hints. Next, is the electrified gate in the Arcanum keeping something out or keeping something in? Kingsala responded, "That is an interesting question. I would think that if the gate was designed to keep something in, then it would be on the other side of the door. But perhaps there's a gate there as well? Now that I think about it, however, which direction is inside and which direction is out?" Alright, so what exactly is Kingsala saying here? You guys are like, what? What kind of sense does that make? That doesn't make any sense. And I kind of agree, but I think that they're pretty smart with the way that they word some of the things that they say. And I don't think that the response by this Kingsala employee to this player who asks the question of what the gate is and is it holding something in or something out is completely crazy, because it's raising the question of which direction is inside and which direction is out. And that basically is asking, is the main part of the Arcanum, or what we think is the main part of the Arcanum, actually where everything is located? Or is what's inside of this gate where everything is located? The Arcanum was actually founded by a bunch of scholars who came together and had a vision for the Arcanum, or they were told by someone higher to create the Arcanum. And they had a dispute over what direction to go in. Some of them wanted to found the Cabal and restore the First World, and another part of them wanted to just build the Arcanum and basically follow the vision of what Grandmother Raven has today. So the part of them that believed in having the Cabal studied in here before they eventually had conflict with the other side of the group and they ended up fleeing. And whatever is in here is what they used to study and where they used to study. So if we're asking which direction really is inside of the Arcanum and which direction is out, that basically means that this part could be a distraction from our wizards of what's really in there, and that what's in here is actually what's important. So yeah, it might not have made sense the way it was worded, but still makes for a pretty interesting theory. Do our wizards come from Earth? Kingsala says, it does seem as though Ambrose is referring to Earth in the tutorial, though perhaps the people of the Spiral know it by another name. I have no idea how we travel to the Spiral from here. Is that where all this VR business is going? Alright, so in that last secret for this video, Kingsala talks about whether or not our wizards came from Earth, and they say that perhaps we did, but the people of the Spiral might know it as another name, and that basically may confirm the fact that the wizards came from a world in the Spiral, but we don't know what the name of that is. And also, they talk about how perhaps maybe that's where all this VR business is going for, and I think they're referring to virtual reality headsets in the real world with, you know, playing video games on your headset and having the hopeful immersive experience. And you could say maybe our wizards came from the real world and we were playing a video game and we're stuck in the Spiral, like it's, you know, Sword Art Online or something. I don't know if you guys have seen that anime, but that could be what they're talking about, or it could just be a joke, you know. Not everything is that serious. So yeah, that was the final answer. And those aren't all the secrets of the Spiral. Kingsala has confirmed many other small details players of the game have mentioned, but there are still a number of mysterious parts of the game Kingsala has never acknowledged. There are so many theories to create when exploring the unique worlds of Wizard 101. But I hope you all enjoyed the video. In case you're wondering where I got the questions and answers that were in the video from, those actually came from a forum that Kingsala created themselves in early 2016, last year, and they basically created the forum to answer questions that players had relating to the game, and most of the players asked storyline questions that they felt were never really answered, secrets that were hidden in the game, and the employees responded themselves and gave some really intriguing answers. So I decided to make a video on it, and there's still a lot of answers that they gave that I didn't include in this video, so I would like to make a part 2 sometime in the future. But my next vid will be on a Wizard 101 ideas, and if you would like to see that, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you are new, and I will see you guys in the next vid. Peace.